Put a modern spin on your game with the Prince Vortex 310. Featuring a cutting-edge V-throat design and a unique 14x21 string pattern, the Prince Vortex 310 Gram delivers an impressive combination of speed, spin, and pinpoint control on full swings. Prince's signature texture material is placed in the hoop and shaft of the frame for a comfortable and responsive feel, while the 320 swing weight and 9 points headlight balance make it easy to whip up enough power to keep your opponent scrambling. This was a playtest where I needed to play into the racket a bit, get used to that feel and response, but after a couple hits, I was really having fun with this racket. It's definitely a racket where you can play around with your spin levels. If you're someone who likes to hit those high arcing balls, this is definitely a racket that's going to cater to those shots. Not only can you get those balls arcing high and landing deep, but they just bounce so high off the ground that it's really trips up your opponent. So that became definitely a weapon when I was on the defense. If I was scrambling out wide, first of all, this racket has great maneuverability, so it was easy to get around the ball fast and get those balls looping up so that I could reset and get back into position. I was also impressed with how controlled the response was playing off of pace. I'm a counterpuncher at heart, and this definitely played well into that game style. The only place I got tripped up on a little was when I got that pop-up ball or short ball where I wanted to just take a big cut and rip a winner. I needed to be sure that I put enough spin on the ball to keep those balls in the court and on target. Moving up to net, I thought this was a seamless transition, easy to get into position. I loved the feel of the racket at net. There were hints of instability at time, but it was nothing that really threw off my game or pushed my shots off mark. And then moving over to serves, also effortless to step up and serve with this racket. There wasn't any wow factor for me on serves, but definitely a lot of spin to tap into. And even when I felt like I wasn't getting the racket moving super fast overhead, the ball seemed to have good momentum moving to the court. So it was offering me enough to get those points started off well. So overall, this was a really fun playtest. It's definitely a unique racket. And if you're someone that likes to use spin as a weapon in your game, this is definitely one to check out.
Hey guys, I really enjoyed playtesting the Prince Vortex 310. I will say it was a tough one for me to crack. With the string pattern being 14x21, I felt like I had a different opinion about how I felt with the racket each time I was able to get out and hit with it. When hitting from the baseline, I noticed I had to shorten up my ground strokes. I had to shorten up my swing, so I was able to get better contact with the racket, which allowed me to have solid rallies from the baseline. You're able to get great amount of spin with this racket, which allows you to push your partner back or your opponent when you're playing. I will say when driving with this, I lost control and my ball would fly, so I wasn't too big on that. My favorite shot while using this racket was my slice. I was able to keep the ball low and drive through or off the court no matter where I placed it. I also really enjoyed chipping and charging with this racket, so that was a lot of fun. When I got to the net, my volleys, I was able to feel the whole ball on the racket, which allowed me to place my volley wherever I needed to, short, deep, off the court, so I really enjoyed that. When it came to serving, I was able to get a great amount of topspin on my kick serve, which allowed me to move my opponent off the court, and also the same thing with my slice. You're really able to move your opponent off the court with this racket. Overall, with the Prince Vortex, it's not for my play style, but I really enjoy playing with it.
Hey guys, this is Andrew coming at you with the Vortex 310. Now, right off the bat, this racket does definitely have some unique characteristics in the string pattern being 14x21. The other specs, though, pretty much are going to be geared towards that intermediate to advanced player frame. So you got the heavier racket at 310, pretty headlight balance at 30.5 centimeters unstrung, and it's got a pretty low swing rate around 285. So basically what you're going to find with this, especially compared to the 300 version, this is going to give you a little bit more of that plow through from that extra 10 grams with a really similar swing weight of 285. Now let's talk about that from the baseline. For me personally, I noticed that counter punches, which is what I'm normally doing, felt really comfortable. So when I was having pace come at me, it was pretty easy to redirect and block that pace back with kind of more of those half swings and those punches. I will say when the ball did slow down and I wanted to speed up my racket though, I was tending to hit the ball a little bit long. So that launch angle is going to be something to just be a little bit more careful of. So if you're a big spin hitter, you will appreciate the fact that this thing generates a ton of spin and has really good plow through, especially against those big hitters. At the net, I really like the racket at the net. So it's got, again, great stability, even though it is a little bit lower at that 63 RA. So it's comfortable, but at the net, the volleys felt super responsive. I will say, again, with the 14x21 pattern, the ball did loft a little bit high on me when I was trying to kind of do more of touch volleys. So I actually wanted to go a little bit more with a more punchy, more powerful volley. But overall, felt really nice, easy to control. For serves, spin serves, big kicks, big slices, I really appreciated the fact of that string pattern on that. However, with my bigger first serves that I tend to hit more flat, it was a little bit inconsistent with that string pattern. So if you're a big serve hitter with a lot of spin, you'll get a lot of benefit out of this racket here. And then lastly, going to returns, again, with that counter-punching, big serves coming at me, really appreciated the fact that this racket could speed up quick and get out in front of the ball. However, again, on those second serves where I wanted to get up to the ball quickly, maybe take the ball up high on a slower serve, I did have some trouble getting my control that I'm typically used to with a racket in this specification range. But overall, other than that, played really great. It's definitely one to check out if you're a big hitter who uses a ton of spin. Just be careful if you're more of a flat hitter because this ball will raise a little bit up on you with that string pattern. For this review, we strung the Prince Vortex 310 with Prince Diablo and Prince Vortex Triad at 52 pounds. For more information on this racket and others, be sure to check out Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, and Tennis Only.